The Bombay High Court adjourned declined to issue directions to the Speaker to dispose of the disqualification petitions pending before him within a time frame, instead expressing its hope and trust that the Speaker, who had taken a stand, would be disposing the petitions expeditiously. Hearing a petition filed by former Goa State Congress President Girish Shodankar, who approached the High Court alleging that the Speaker had violated the outer limit of 90 days, a precedent that was set by the Supreme Court in the case of Keshav Meghachandra Singh versus Speaker Manipur Legislative Assembly and others, the High Court felt that while the Speaker is bound to decide the disqualifications within a reasonable period, there existed exceptional circumstances because of which it would not be appropriate to direct the Speaker in the present case.
Today, the division bench of the Honorable High Court has pronounced a judgment in the petition filed by Mr. Girish Shodankar. Basically, the petition was seeking a direction to the Speaker to decide our disqualification petition in time-bound manner. The major contention of the Speaker was that the court cannot direct the Speaker to decide the disqualification petition. High Court cannot direct. Today, in the judgment, the Honorable High Court has held that in terms of the law laid down by the judgment of the Supreme Court in Keshav Chandra, which is binding on the High Court, the Speaker acts as a tribunal, and therefore the Honorable High Court can direct the Speaker to decide the petition, and that has to be decided within reasonable time. The High Court has accepted our contention that the Honorable High Court has the power to direct the Speaker to decide the petition in a time-bound manner. In the present case, the High Court has held that since on the affidavit Speaker has stated that he is in process of deciding the petition filed by Mr. Amit Patkar in July 1st, and his process is in process of deciding. They are not giving any outer limit to decide, but the court has said that we expect and hope that whatever statement the Speaker has made in the affidavit, that they are going to expeditiously decide all the petition, would be adhered to, and they will follow the judgment in Keshav Chandra, wherein the Supreme Court has said that you should decide such disqualification petition in a reasonable time and within 3 months. We welcome the judgment because it laid down a law to say that the High Court has the power to decide the Speaker, and that was the major contention of the Speaker, that you cannot direct us. That has been repelled, and our contention has been upheld that the Honorable High Court can certainly direct the Speaker. We welcome that decision. As far as the remaining portion, we'll have to read the detailed judgment, which we await. Obviously, by evening, the judgment will come. We'll read it and we'll see what is.
Should intervene because of unnecessary delay by the Honorable Speaker. So, High Court today, the verdict was read out. They have said they can direct. So, that is one plus point for our second prayer was that to give the direct the Speaker to give the judgment in the time-bound manner. We never prayed for a specific days. We referred the Manipur judgment, and accordingly we had requested the Honorable High Court to give the direction to the Speaker. And we are happy today that one thing is that the Honorable High Court has directed can direct the Speaker. Number two, whatever we prayed, that it should be within the time bound that is set by the Supreme Court. We never prayed for the specific days to be directed. And the Honorable High Court's order today also says that within the time bound, as per the order given by the Honorable High Court of the in the Manipur matter.
So I just want to know, apart from this legal issue, one thing, political issue.
For Prime Reporter, Tukaram Marathe, Panji.